Hey there, John from My Solar Home. This latest video is about the best solar generators 2023. All the 10 generators that I've covered in this review are super products. You'll be happy with any one of them. We'll start with the portable solar generators. These are the smallest ones. And the first in our list is the Anker 256 portable solar generator. This good looking compact unit weighs about 8.2 pounds and it is perfect for your camping trip. Small and easy to carry. The Anker 256 with a bright, easy to see display. Let's look at what the Anker 256 can power. You'll be able to charge your iPhone or your GoPro camera about 51 times with this unit. A laptop, including a Mac, you'll be able to charge it about 4 times before the battery runs out. A mini fridge or a CPAP machine that consumes about 75 watts an hour, you'll be able to charge the CPAP machine 3 times or run your mini fridge for about 3 hours. Smaller tools like power drills or a drone can be charged about 2 times. A regular 50-inch TV can run for about 2 hours, so it's got decent power. You could even run your home fridge for about an hour with the Anker 256. But beyond that, the Anker 256 won't be able to handle a desktop computer or a blender, anything above 200 watts, you'll not be able to run that. Now, in terms of the specs for the Anker 256, this weighs about 8.2 pounds. It's got a battery capacity of 256 watt hours, and the maximum AC power that it can generate is about 200 watts. Now, the good thing about the Anker 256 is that it's powered by lithium ferrous phosphate, LiFePO4 batteries. Now, these last very long. They can last for about 10 years. So it's an excellent battery that powers this unit. It's priced at about $219 on Amazon, and it's got a lot of reviews. There are 1245 reviews. So in terms of outputs, you've got 2 USB outputs, which are pretty good at 15 watts each. A USB-C output, which is at 60 watts. 2 AC outputs, 200 watts. And of course, a cigarette charger output where you can plug in anything which you can plug into your car. Recharge times are very good. 0 to 80% in just 1 hour and 30 minutes. And this unit enjoys one of the industry's best 5-year warranties. Next, we have the Jackery 300. Again, very good looking product. And Jackery comes from a long line of solar generator makers. They've been in the US for many years. Extremely strong support. Their products are rugged, and this is no exception. The Jackery 300 watt can power iPhone or your GoPro for about 58 times. You'll be able to charge your laptop almost 5 times, 4.5 times. A mini fridge will run for about 3.5 hours, and you'll be able to charge your CPAP machine, which consumes about 75 watts, for about 3.5 times. Tools and drones, which consume about 100 watts, you'll be able to charge them for about 2 to 2.5 times. A large TV you'd be able to run for about 2 hours, assuming they consume about 120 watts. A home fridge would run for about 1.5 hours. You could even run a desktop computer with the Jackery 300 because it's got a higher AC output at 300 watts. But anything beyond 300 watts, like the blender, microwave, etc., are beyond the power capacity of this unit. The Jackery 300 overall, again, an excellent buy. 6,755 reviews on Amazon. At $299, it's very competitively priced. A max power output of 300 watts, a battery capacity of 293 watt hours, which makes it slightly better than the Anker 250. We looked at earlier. At 7.1 pounds, it is definitely lighter than the Anker 256. In terms of outputs, it has the same range of outputs as the Anker 256 with 2 USBs, a USB-C at 60 watts, 2 AC outputs, 300 watts in total, cigarette lighter charger output. And again, quick charging is available, though not as quick as the Anker 256, 0 to 80% in 2 hours. The Jackery 300 has a lithium ion battery. The next is the EcoFlow 288. The EcoFlow 288 is from a company which knows what it's doing. The EcoFlow range of products, whether it's a portable to a large generator, have extremely good reputations in the market. And the EcoFlow 288 is again beautifully designed product, as you can see, easy to carry around with you. In terms of what it can charge, the EcoFlow has got 288 watt hours of capacity. If you compare it with the Jackery was at about 293 watt hours and the Anker was 256 watt hours. So this is in the middle at about 288 watt hours. What the EcoFlow does better than the other two is that it's got a larger power output up to 600 watts. So that means you can run bigger devices. Not that you can run them for long, but you'll be able to run bigger devices than you can with the Jackery or the Anker. For example, the Eco 288, you could even run a microwave for about 20 minutes or a blender for about 45 minutes. These are two devices which you cannot run with either the Anker or the Jackery. Similarly, you could run a desktop computer for about 50 minutes. A laptop, you know, you could recharge it about four times, run your TV or your Xbox games for about 2 hours or so. So it's a pretty decently powered generator. What it does better than its peers is able to output more energy quicker. As a result, you're able to run bigger devices, which the other two can't. Overall specs, if you look at the product, again, extremely well reviewed on Amazon with 1,903 reviews. And it's got a super price at $219. It's a shade heavier at 11 pounds. It's a lithium-ion battery. It's got a big range of outputs. It's got two regular USBs, 15 watts each, a fast charging USB as well. So that's three USB ports in total, 100 watt USB-C port, so that's super. Two DC 12 volt ports, three AC outputs, that total 600 watts, and a cigarette charger output. With the EcoFlow 288, you're able to add extra batteries, which is a significant benefit. If you like this unit and you want more capacity, just buy another 288 watt hour capacity battery. It fixes to the bottom of the unit and bingo, you're at 576 watt hours of capacity. The fourth portable solar generator we're looking at is the Bluity 268. This is my favorite among the four portable solar generators. It's a 268 watt hour unit, easy to carry around and great for trips. All the portable generators have pretty good displays with input, output and state of charge indicated in them, and the Bluity 268 has a good display as well. The Bluity is powered by a lithium ferrous phosphate battery and it's got a large inverter. And like the EcoFlow 288, it's got a max AC power of 600 watts, which allows it to really play beyond the portable solar generator category and power much larger devices. Let's look at what this guy can do. It can charge an iPhone or a GoPro for about 53 times, and you can charge power tools like your drill, charge your drone for about two times, a large home fridge for about an hour or so, a TV for about 2 hours. It's able to run your blender for about 45-50 minutes. You'll be able to run your desktop computer for about 50 minutes with this unit. You might even be able to run your microwave if it's a shade under 600 watts. This unit is powered by a lithium ferrous phosphate battery. These are the best type of batteries in the market. They'll give your solar generator a life of at least 10 years. This unit weighs about 10.14 pounds. Recharging is really, really fast with this one. It's the fastest recharge available, 0 to 80% in just 30 minutes. It's got more outputs than its peers, including wireless charging for your phones, two AC charge outlets, the cigarette charger outlet, DC 12 volt outlets. It's got a 100 watt USB-C output and two 15 watt regular USB outputs. So you've got a whole range of outputs powered by the best in class lithium ferrous phosphate batteries, awesome power, 2,562 reviews, and a wonderful $209 price, the best in the range. And that makes the Bluity 268 a winner in my list. Next, let's look at mid-sized solar generators. A mid-sized solar generator has a battery capacities in the region of about 500 watt hours compared to the portable solar generators, which are in the 200 to 300 watt hour battery capacity range. The first mid-sized solar generator we're looking at is the GrowWatt 538 watt hour. The GrowWatt has a nice powerful LCD light, got a nice big wireless charging pad right on top. Your phone or GoPro can be charged 107 times with the GrowWatt 538. A laptop will get close to 9 charges. You'll be able to keep a mini fridge running for about 7 hours. Power tools like your mini drills could be charged for about 5 times. Regular size TV for about 4 hours. 2.5 hours of power for your larger refrigerators. You could run a desktop computer for about an hour and a half. The GrowWatt has 600 watts of power output, which incidentally is in the same range as the Bluity 268 we looked at earlier. But with 600 watts of output power, it could run a microwave for about 50 minutes. But anything more than 600 watts, like your coffee grinder or your electric saw or your window AC, you won't be able to run with the GrowWatt 538. 18 pounds, so it's obviously a mid-size generator, a little heavier. It hasn't been in the market for very long, but it's got very good reviews, 33 of them so far. It retails at about $489. It comes with state-of-the-art lithium ferrous phosphate batteries. This solar generator is going to last you for about 10 years very easily. Charging time is very good, 0 to 80% in just an hour or so. Max power of 600 is great. It's got three USB output ports. Two of them are 12 watts, a shade underpowered, and one which is 18 watts, which is for fast charging. But the USB-C port is good at 100 watts, two 12-volt DC outputs, and three AC outlets, which will give you a total of 600 watts. And it's got a cigarette lighter charger as well. Our second mid-size solar generator is the EcoFlow 768. The EcoFlow has a whole range of solar generators from small to large, and the 768 is an exceptional product in the mid-size range. The EcoFlow 2 has got an outstanding 800 watts of output power. As a result, it's able to power almost everything which is there on this list. The only two devices which it cannot power are your electric saw and the window AC, but anything up to a coffee grinder is fine for the EcoFlow River 2. You can run your coffee grinder for about 15 minutes. You can run your microwave for about 1.2 hours. A desktop computer will run for about 3.3 hours. You recharge your mini reel at least 7 times, so you can keep running it the whole day of this unit. A laptop can be charged for about 12 times. You can even run your home fridge for about 3.5 hours. It's got a capacity of 768 watt hours, and it's lighter than its peers at about 17 pounds. The EcoFlow is powered by lithium ferrous phosphate battery, which again give it a long life. EcoFlow is again new in the market, so it doesn't have so many reviews, but all the reviews are great. 50 reviews so far, and with a price of $599, a little pricier than its peers, but again, this is a super product. The EcoFlow River 2 768 watt unit has 5-hour warranty, which is amongst the best in the market today. The EcoFlow River 2 is an outstanding product, and it came a very close second to my favorite mid-size generator, which is the Runhood 600. The Runhood Rally 600 product has won design awards across various forums in the US. Is perhaps the only generator which has swappable batteries. You can actually plug and play the batteries, put the batteries in, replace the batteries, do this while you're charging the unit or while you're using the unit. One of the advantages of the Runhood 600, as you can see in this picture, is that you can carry the unit without the batteries. You can carry the batteries separately. That makes it much lighter at about 9 pounds. Both the batteries, the unit weighs about 18 pounds. This has got 648 watt hours of capacity. That's good enough to get you 129 charges on your iPhone or your GoPro. You can charge your laptop for about 10 times. You can run your mini fridge for about 8 hours. Your power tool drills at least 6 times with this battery. You can run your TV, a 50-inch TV, for about 5 hours. 3 hours of runtime for your home fridge. You won't be able to run anything larger than 600 watts with this. So the base Runhood Rally 600 unit comes with two of these batteries, giving it a total capacity of 648 watt hours. The Runhood 600 pretty much has everything in its favor, except it's a tad underpowered if you compare it with the EcoFlow River 2, which has got 800 watts of output versus the Runhood 600. Two quick charging USB power outputs, at each outputting 28 watts, which is really good. The USB-C port at 100 watt is the max that's possible. Two DC 12 volt outputs, a cigarette charger lighter output, and of course you've got two AC outputs, which give you a total of 600 watts. One of the advantages of the Runhood swappable batteries is that you can swap the batteries while the unit is running. So technically, if you bought two extra batteries, you can extend the energy capacity of your unit to 1296 watt hours. That means with four batteries, you have 1296 watt hours. Just keep two batteries on standby. When two of them run out, you can swap them with these two. The Runhood hasn't been in the market for very long, but it's got excellent reviews with 171 reviews, and it's retailing for $699. So this is my winner in the mid-size solar generator category. And now let's get on to the larger full-size generators. So the first full-size solar generator review is the GoalZero 1000X. GoalZero again comes from a company which has got a long history of making excellent, very rugged products. The 1000X has got 983 watt hours of capacity, and it's able to output 1000 watts, which can run most devices that you have in your home. It can charge your iPhone for about 196 times, your laptop for about 16 times. You can charge your CPAP machine for about 13 times, mini fridge for about 13 hours, power your mini drill for about 9 charges, run your TV for about 8 hours, 4.5 hours of runtime for your home fridge. You can run a desktop computer for about 3 hours, a microwave for about 1.5 hours, and a coffee grinder for about 1.2 hours. You will not be able to run an electric saw or window AC because the GoalZero 1000 has a max output of 1000 watts. The GoZero 1000 weighs about 37 pounds, powered by a lithium ion battery. Again, good reviews in the market, 40 of them. It retails at $1,299. The GoZero 1000X has got a USB-C output, which maxes out at 60 watt, which is a shade disappointing. It's got two USB 12 watt outputs and an 18 watt quick charger. So again, slightly underpowered. A cigarette lighter charger. And of course, it's a US-based company. You get US-based support. Next, we have the Anker 757, a new product in the market. Again, outstandingly featured. It's right in the middle in terms of energy and power capacity. The Anker 757 has got 1,229 watt-hours of battery capacity. And its power output is very, very good at 1,500 watts. The other thing which is outstanding about the 757 is its lithium ferrous phosphate battery. Let's look at what this guy can power in terms of devices. It's going to give you about 45 minutes of energy for your window AC. You could run a power tool like your electric saw for about an hour, a coffee grinder for about 1.4 hours. You can run a microwave for almost close to 2 hours. A regular fridge can run for about 6 hours. 245 charges for your iPhone or your GoPro, 20 charges for your laptops. If you look at the pricing and reviews on Amazon, again, very good. It's slightly new in the market, so it's got 168 reviews. $1,099. It is very aggressively priced, well below the $1,299 of GoZero 1000 we looked at. The lithium ferrous phosphate battery is a fantastic long life battery. It'll last you for at least 10 years. The Anker 757 charges from 0 to 80% in 1 hour, which is outstanding for these large solar generators. It's got a range of outputs, two USB-C 100 watt outputs, which is fabulous. The USB regular outputs, there are four of them. Of course, at 12 watts, they're slightly lower power than what I would have liked them to be. But with 1500 watts of AC power, you've got six AC outlets. So that's a lot of devices you can run together at one time, including a cigarette lighter charger for devices that you normally run in your car. The Anker 757 came a close second in full-size solar generator category. My final product, the Jackery 2000, weighs about 43 pounds and it's got a nice handle and form factor. Biggest capacity solar generator that I've reviewed. It's able to output 2,200 watts, which means it can run pretty much anything which you have in your home or your tool shed. You can charge your phone 432 times with this unit. You can run your regular fridge for about 10 hours. You can power a window AC too with this unit, which is really not possible with any of the other units. An electric saw can easily be powered with this. It'll run it for close to 2 hours. A coffee grinding machine for about 2.5 hours. You can run a microwave for at least 3 hours with the Jackery 2000. Jackery is a really solid product. The design has been improving generation to generation, and this latest one has got 230 reviews. It retails at about $1,849, which is extremely well priced for this size of solar generator. It comes with a lithium ion battery and it weighs about 43 pounds. Charging time has significantly improved for such a large solar generator. To charge 0 to 100% in 2 hours is awesome. And Jackery, with US support now, is offering you 5-year warranties on this battery. It's got a lot of outputs, two 18 watt USB outputs, 200 watt USB-C outputs, three AC outputs that give you a total of 2200 watts. Excellent reviews, 230 of them. Jackery 2000 is my choice for the best solar generator full size. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Do like and subscribe and have a great day.